वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग विथ नेक्स्ट टॉपिक विच इज स्पेस फोर्सेस. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड फोर्सेस इन स्पेस. नाउ प्रीवियसली वी हैव स्टडीड फोर्सेस मोमेंट रिजल्टेंट, बट इट वॉज फॉर टू डायमेंशनल प्लेन. ओके, सो वी हैव स्टडीड कोप्लेनर फोर्स सिस्टम. ओके, नाउ हियर स्पेस फोर्सेस आर देयर, सो वी विल बी हैविंग थ्री कोऑर्डिनेट्स एक्स वाई एंड जेड, एंड द फोर्स डायरेक्शन इट कुड बी एनी वेयर, एंड डिपेंडिंग ऑन द कोऑर्डिनेट एक्स वाई जेड वी हैव टू फाइंड रिजल्टेंट और वॉट एवर इज आस्क्ड इन द क्वेश्चन. नाउ यूजुअली द टाइप ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल्स विच यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट इन दिस टॉपिक दे आर लिस्टेड ओवर हियर. सो वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस स्पेस फोर्सेस दैट इज लिस्टेड ओवर हियर, फर्स्ट इज फोर्स वेक्टर, then moment of a force about a given point. So force vector is given or force magnitude of force is given. So how to take moment about a given point, that will be for space forces. Then resultant of concurrent force system in space, resultant of parallel force system in space, and resultant of general force system in space. So we will see first the applications of this space forces. So here few applications are listed. You can observe first application. Okay, some component is there and it is held because of these four ropes, okay, in this hook. So this is an example of concurrent force system in space. Then one more example here, you can see a hook is there which is inserted in some of the machine part. And then again ropes are there, and ropes are being pulled in all the three directions, okay, x, y and z. So this is again example of space force. Then third example here, you can see some boom is there, okay, some machine part is there which is actually holding this horizontal slab. Okay, so here again there are three ropes involved and hooks are there. So again this is example of concurrent force system in space. One more example here, you can see a pole is there and flag is there. Now because of the wind, there will be a lot of resistance over here, okay, the flag, there will be a lot of resistance, and because of that there will be load on this column, okay, where flag is attached. So to prevent the bending of the column or to hold the column in proper way, here you can see ropes are provided, okay, and they are attached to ground. So again this is space force example. Next example here, you can see an electrical tower is there, sometimes that is also held with the help of ropes with ground. One more example, a hook is there and it is being, here you can see there are three ropes attached, okay, F1, F2, F3, three forces are acting in all the three directions, x, y and z. Again this is application of forces in space. Then this is jhumbar, okay, it is also called chandelier. So here you can see again these are different forces acting, and again this is example of forces in space. Next example, here you can see we have two poles and in between net is there. So here you can consider this example as either volleyball net or badminton net, okay. So if this pole, it is being tied like this to the ground, that is also example of space forces. There will be tension in this rope, okay, all the three ropes on this side as well as that side, there will be tension. So these are examples of some examples of space forces. Next examples we will see, this is hot air balloon. Okay, now in order to hold this hot air balloon to the ground, okay, here you can see ropes are being tied at three location, B, C and D. Okay, so again this is, here you can see axis coordinate system has been given, x axis is there, y axis is there and z axis is there. So these are example of forces in space. So first we will see force vector F bar. Okay, now this force vector, it will be equal to, this is a vector F bar which is in space. Okay, now if line of action of force F in space passes through point A and point B, what is coordinate of point A? X1, Y1, Z1. Okay, here it is shown. And point B coordinate is X2, Y2, Z2. Then if we want to find force vector, okay, how to get this? We have to multiply by magnitude of force. Okay, here magnitude is given, so F multiplied by unit vector of AB. Okay, it will be E bar AB. Okay, so here if you simplify this, you will get F into, this will become AB bar upon mod of AB bar. Okay, so here you have to write for point B. Okay, X2 minus X1 I plus Y2 minus Y1 J plus Z2 minus Z1 K divided by under root of X2 minus X1 square plus Y2 minus Y1 square plus Z2 minus Z1 square. Okay, using this we will get force vector F bar, okay, which is equal to Fx I plus Fy J plus Fz K. Now what is Fx here? Fx is equal to F cos theta X, Fy is equal to F cos theta Y, and Fz is equal to F cos theta Z. Okay, now what is this theta X, theta Y and theta Z? These angles are known as force direction and its value lies between 0 and 180. Okay, so theta X, theta Y, theta Z, they are known as force direction and value lies between 0 and 180 degree. Now if the value, okay, it is greater than, if value of theta X, theta Y, theta Z, it is greater than 90 degree, meaning that force component is negative. Okay, then from here we can write down magnitude of force as well. Force will be equal to under root of Fx square plus Fy square plus Fz square. And by direction cosine rule, what we can write, okay, where you might have studied this before, okay, alpha, beta, gamma, cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma equal to 1. By direction cosine rule, we have cos square theta X plus cos square theta Y plus cos square theta Z equal to 1. So this is about force vector. Next we will see how to take moment of force which is there in space about given point. Okay, so force vector F bar, it is equal to F magnitude of force into unit vector. Okay, this equation we have already seen. So this is the force vector F bar, Fxi plus Fyj plus Fzk. Okay, now position vector, here you can see this is the force from A to B, F. Okay, and this you can consider this as vector F bar. Now what is the position vector here? Direction is from C to A. Okay, so position vector is RCA. Now this position vector, what are the coordinates given? First point, if you see the this coordinate of point C, it is X3, Y3, Z3. Coordinate of A, it is X1, Y1, Z1, and coordinate of B, it is X2, Y2, Z2. So we have to take moment of this force vector about point C. So what is position vector? It will be X1 minus X3i plus Y1 minus Y3j plus Z1 minus Z3k. Okay, so RCA position vector is Xi plus Yj plus Zk. Now what will be moment vector MC? Okay, so moment about point C, it will be cross product. Okay, so moment vector, it will be cross product of position vector and force vector. Okay, so you have to do the cross product here, ijk, then RCA, what is the value? X, Y and Z. Okay, so X, Y, Z, and force, what are the values? Fx, Fy, Fz. Okay, then by solving this matrix, you will get moment vector, which is Mxi plus Myj plus Mzk. Okay, with this, we can solve numericals related to moment vector. Now we have already discussed this part, force vector. Okay, a force has been given in space passing through point A and B. ओके सो फोर्स वेक्टर पार्ट मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ फोर्स एंड देन थीटा एक्स थीटा वाई थीटा जेड दिस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. वील सॉल्व सम न्यूमेरिकल नाउ. फोर्स एफ बार इज इक्वल टू 3i माइनस 4j प्लस 12k न्यूटन. ओके सो वील शो अ वेक्टर ओवर हियर. दिस इज फोर्स वेक्टर. एफ बार इज इक्वल टू 3i माइनस 4j प्लस 12k न्यूटन. Acts at a point A and that coordinate of point A is given. So suppose this is point A. A coordinates are 1, minus 2 and 3. Okay, now what is asked? Moment of force about origin. Origin means O coordinate will be 0, 0, 0. Okay, so we will show origin first. So I have shown origin and what is the position vector? It will be r bar OA. Then what is the second sub question given here? Moment of force about point B and B coordinates are given over here. So we'll show a point B as well here. Okay, randomly I am showing that. Suppose this is point B. So this will be r bar BA. Position vector. This is point B. Coordinate of point B is 2, 1, 2 meter. Now what is unit of moment? It is Newton meter. Okay, so we'll solve this numerical now. Force vector it is given as F bar equal to 3i minus 4j plus 12k. Okay, now position vector we have to calculate. Okay, first position vector it will be OA position vector. Okay, it will be A minus O. Okay, A coordinates minus O. Okay, so this will be 1 minus 0 I, then minus 2, minus 0, j, plus 3, minus 0, k. Okay, so as it is, we have to write it down. 1 I, minus 2, j, plus 3, k. Second, it will be position vector B, A. Okay, that value will be it is BA, right? So A minus B we have to consider. So 1 minus 2 I so second we can write down plus minus 2 then minus 1 J plus 3 minus 2k. Okay, so this is the position vector. We can simplify this. It will be minus I minus 3j plus k. Okay, so position vector we have calculated for both the cases which are asked in the numerical. Next we will calculate moment vector. Now moment vector, okay, so first moment vector, it will be moment of force vector about point O. Okay, so it will be cross product ROA into F bar. Okay, so we have to write the values here. position vector, what are the values 1, minus 2, 3. And fourth vector, it is 3, minus 4, 12. Okay, now you can calculate this. So what will be I value? It will be minus 24 minus of minus 12. Okay, so plus 12 I. Then next will be J. Okay, it will be 12 minus 9. So minus 12 minus 9 J. And last one K. It will be minus 4 minus of minus 6. Okay, so plus minus 4 plus 6 K. Okay, now you can simplify this. You will get minus 12 I minus 3 J plus 2 K Newton meter. This is moment vector about point O. Next, we have to calculate moment about point B. This will be position vector BA into force, okay, cross product. Okay, now we'll see the position vector value minus 1, minus 3, 1. Then force vector 3 minus 4, 12. Okay, now you can solve this. First one will be I. Okay, so plus 12 into minus 3 minus 36 minus of minus 4. So plus 4 I. Then for J, it will be minus of in bracket minus 12 minus 3. Okay, so minus of minus 12 minus 3 J plus. For K, it will be 4 minus of minus 9. 4 plus 9 K. Okay, so moment vector, it will be minus 32 I plus 15 J plus 13 K Newton meter. Okay, now in this question, what was given? Force vector was given. Okay, and we calculated what is the moment of this force vector about point O and about point B. Now in next question, magnitude of force is given. Okay, and we have to take moment of that force about point, whatever given point is there. Okay, so we'll see that question now. Okay, now in this question, a force of 1200 Newton acts along PQ. P coordinate is given and Q coordinate is given. Calculate its moment about point A. A coordinate is given. So I'll show the vector first. So this is vector PQ. Okay, it is passing through point P and Q. P is 4, 5, minus 2. And Q coordinates are given minus 3, 1, 6. Now we have to take moment of this force. What is the magnitude of force? Force PQ. It is equal to 1200 Newton. We have to take moment of this force about point A. Okay, now that point A I'll show. So point A coordinates are given here 3, 2, 0. Position vector, it will be AP. Okay, so first what we will do here, magnitude of फोर्स इज गिवन. ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू गेट फोर्स वेक्टर वैल्यू. ओके, देन आफ्टर गेटिंग द फोर्स वेक्टर वी विल गेट पोजिशन वेक्टर एंड देन वी हैव टू डू क्रॉस प्रोडक्ट. ओके, सो आई विल राइट डाउन फोर्स वेक्टर. सो फोर्स वेक्टर इट विल बी एफ बार पी क्यू इक्वल टू एफ पी क्यू इंटू यूनिट वेक्टर. ओके, सो दिस विल बी 1200 इंटू यूनिट वेक्टर. सो वी हैव टू राइट डाउन दिस वन नाउ. ओके, सो दिस पॉइंट माइनस दिस पॉइंट, राइट, क्यू माइनस पी. ओके, सो माइनस थ्री माइनस फोर आई. ओके, इट विल बी माइनस सेवन आई. देन वन माइनस फाइव जे, सो माइनस फोर जे एंड देन सिक्स माइनस ऑफ माइनस टू. ओके, सो एट के डिवाइडेड बाय अंडर रूट ऑफ सेवन स्क्वेयर प्लस फोर स्क्वेयर प्लस एट स्क्वेयर. सो वी कैन कैलकुलेट फोर्स वेक्टर. फोर्स वेक्टर माइनस सेवन थर्टी नाइन पॉइंट फाइव सेवन एट आई माइनस फोर ट्वेंटी टू पॉइंट सिक्स वन सिक्स जे प्लस एट फोर्टी फाइव पॉइंट टू के. नाउ वी विल कैलकुलेट पोजिशन वेक्टर. पोजिशन वेक्टर ए पी इट विल बी पी माइनस ए. ओके, सो फोर माइनस थ्री आई देन फाइव माइनस टू जे एंड लास्ट वन इज माइनस टू एंड जीरो. सो माइनस टू, सो माइनस टू के. ओके, देन वी हैव टू फाइंड मोमेंट ऑफ दिस फोर्स वेक्टर अबाउट पॉइंट ए. सो मोमेंट वी हैव टू राइट मोमेंट वेक्टर अबाउट पॉइंट ए. ओके, दिस विल बी इक्वल टू पोजिशन वेक्टर its cross product with force vector. So this value will be for position vector we have 1 then 3 and minus 2. And for force vector these are the values of ijk. So solve this matrix. Okay, I will be 845.2 into 3 minus of this multiplication. Okay, so you can solve this. I'll write down the final answer directly. Moment vector, it is 1690.368 I plus 633. 0.956 J plus 1796.118 K. What is unit of this? Newton meter. Okay, this is second numerical. Then last numerical we will take related to moment part. After that we will see resultant of concurrent. Now understand this question. A force acts at the origin in direction defined by angles theta y, theta z is given. Knowing that the x component of force is minus 750 Newton, determine other components. So we have to determine Fy, Fz. This is Fx given. And since Fx is negative, theta x value, that will be greater than 90. Okay, theta value, it is between 0 to 180. Now, since this is negative Fx, that value will be greater than 90. Magnitude of force we have to find out. Okay, so F we have to find out based on Fx, Fy and Fz. And then we have to find value of theta x. So we'll solve this question. First, we will write by direction cosine rule, we can find out theta y is given, theta z is given. Okay, so we can find theta x value first. So last question we will solve first by direction cosine rule. We can write down cos square theta x plus cos square theta y plus cos square theta z equal to 1. Okay, now substitute all the values here. Cos square theta x plus cos square theta y, it is 65, plus cos square theta z 40 equal to 1. So from here we can calculate this value, cos square theta x equal to 0.234. Okay, from here we can calculate, here calculate this value, what value you are getting, cos theta x. But now issue is, we already know that this force component is negative. So we have to consider that Fx negative sign, and that negative sign needs to be introduced on the right side. Okay, so I'll write it down over here. Consider the negative sign, negative value Fx equal to minus 750 Newton. This is given in question. Okay, Fx is minus 750. So here we need to introduce a negative sign. Okay, so cos theta x, we will write this value as minus 0.483. Then only this angle theta x, it will be greater than 90. Okay, so calculate this value now. So if you don't take the negative sign, that answer will become wrong. So you have to make a note of that point. When x component is given as negative, remember that you have to take a negative sign on this side. Then only you will get angle greater than 90 degree. Okay, so cos theta x, from there we can calculate theta x. Theta x is equal to 118.88 degree. This is one question which is asked. Now, since we have value of theta x and we have value of Fx, we can calculate magnitude of force, that is F. Okay, so I'll write down Fx is equal to F cos theta x. Okay, Fx value, it is minus 750 given in question, equal to F cos 118.88 degree. Okay, so we can calculate F. F is equal to 1552.86 Newton. This is magnitude of force F. Now, since we have theta y, theta z, we have value of force, we can calculate Fy and Fz. Okay, so I'll calculate Fy. Fy is equal to F cos theta y F magnitude 1552.86 cos theta y. It is 65. So Fy is equal to 656.266 Newton. And last part remaining, it is Fz. So Fz equal to F cos theta z equal to 1552.86 into cos of theta z. Theta z is 40 degree. So we can calculate Fz 1189.55 Newton. So we have solved this numerical. Now what was asked? Theta y, theta z is given. Fx is given, which is negative. We have to find other components. Okay, so we have found Fy and Fz, other components. Then magnitude of force F we have to find out. That also we have found out. And next question is value of theta x. Here we have calculated theta x. So we have completed with the numericals on moment. Okay, if you see the question papers, university question papers, based on these three questions only you will find variety. Okay, in one case force vector is given, we have to find moment. In one case magnitude of force is given, we have to find moment. And in one case this theta values are given. Okay, and we have to find. Now we will see resultant of concurrent force system in space. Okay, so here you can see the coordinate system x, y and z has been shown, and this is a point P about which forces are acting in space. Okay, but these are concurrent, okay, passing through a single point only. Okay, now what we have to find out? We have to find out resultant along the same point P. Okay, so here you can see again coordinate system is shown, and the resultant, it is again passing through point P only. So how to solve this type of numerical? We'll see the steps. First we have to find resultant. Okay, so resultant R bar is equal to, it will be F1 bar plus F2 bar plus F3 bar plus F4 bar and so on. Then you have to combine all the I terms, J terms, K terms. Okay, you will get R bar summation Fx I plus summation Fy J plus summation Fz K. So from here, now if you recall previously, we used to write down the equation like this. Rx is equal to summation Fx. Okay, same thing here you can see. Summation Fx we can write as Rx I plus Ry J plus Rz K. So what will be the magnitude of this resultant? This is vector form. So what will be the magnitude? It will be under root of Rx square plus Ry square plus Rz square. Then direction. Here the angle we are considering cos. Okay, so if this resultant, this is hypotenuse. Okay, and angle we are considering theta x, suppose with respect to x axis. Okay, of this resultant. So theta x, theta y and theta z we have to calculate. So that will be cos inverse of Rx upon R theta y, cos inverse of Ry upon R adjacent upon hypotenuse, and theta z cos inverse of Rz upon R. So we'll solve a numerical. Understand the question here. The resultant of three concurrent space forces at A is R equal to -788 J Newton. So here you can see we have x axis, y axis and z axis. Okay, and we have points A, B, C and D. Okay, here you can see some rope or something is tied over here, and the forces are shown F1, F2, F3. Okay, now resultant is given in the question. it depends on the given question. Sometimes forces might be given F1, F2 and F3 and they will ask what is resultant. Here resultant is given and they are asking F1, F2, F3. So it will depend on the type of question. So here resultant is given. Now what is the direction of resultant? It is downward, right? It is minus 788 J. Only J is there. Okay, J means Y component is there. So minus 788 J Newton is resultant. Okay, now next we have to find the magnitude of forces F1, F2, F3. Now how to solve this numerical? First we will write down the coordinates of all the points. Point O, A, B, C and D. Once we know the coordinate, we will find the force vectors F1, F2, F3. Okay, so we have to multiply magnitude of force into unit vector. So we will get force vector, but magnitude is unknown. Then we have resultant, we will equate it with these vectors. And from there, we can equate J is there. Okay, J value is given here, but I and K, they are zero. Okay, so we will equate and we will find F1, F2 and F3. I hope you understood the approach. So first step, I'll write down, we will find all the coordinates. So coordinate of point O, it is 0, 0, 0. Now where students make mistake while finding the coordinates, and coordinates finding, it is the first step. If you do mistake at this initial stage itself, your whole numerical will be wrong. Okay, so initial stage is very important because everything else depends on this coordinates. What is coordinate of A? X, Y, Z. Okay, see this. Here we have X axis. Here we have Y axis and this is Z axis. So if you consider point A, it is vertically in Y direction. X and Z is 0. So X is 0. Y is plus 12. Why? Because it is in upward direction. And Z is also 0. So I'll write down A, 0, 12, 0. Next, we will go for point B. Here you can see B point is in negative direction. Okay, so this will be minus 9. Then Y is 0 and Z is 0. So minus 9, 0, 0. So B point we have found out. Now C point. So X is 0, okay, for point C, X is 0, Y is 0 and Z, this is negative Z, okay, it is given in the question. So it will be plus 5, okay, so 0, 0, 5. Then point D, it is given over here. What is the coordinate of point D? So if you consider point D, this direction is plus X. So it will be plus 3, then Y is 0 and Z, it is negative direction. So minus 4. So D is 3, 0, minus 4. So we have found out the coordinates. So this is about coordinates part. Now second, we will write down force vectors. Now force vector F1. It will be magnitude of force 1 and multiplied by unit vector. Okay, magnitude of force 1, it is unknown, into unit vector, this value. Now understand how to write this. So it is EAB. Okay, so B minus A we have to consider here, and B coordinates, these are A coordinates. So minus 9 and I for A, it is 0. So minus 9i, then 0, minus 12, so minus 12j, and K value, it is 0 only, divided by under root of 9 square plus 12 square. This is first vector f1. Then second vector, it will be equal to f2 into unit vector. Now what is the unit vector f2? It is AC. Okay, so f2 into what are the coordinates? F2 into what are the coordinates? We have to write C minus A. So C minus A. So this will be 0, first one. Second one is 0 and 12. So minus 12j. Then C minus A, right? So 5 minus 0, 5k. Divided by under root of 12 square plus 5 square. So this is force vector 2. Then force vector 3, it will be F3 into what is the direction here? A to D. Okay, now this will be D minus A. Okay, so D minus A, 3 minus 0, 3i, then 0 minus 12, so minus 12j, and then minus 4, 0, so minus 4k, divided by under root of 3 square plus 12 square plus 4 square. So this is force vector 3. This is second step. Now third we will see resultant. Resultant R, it is equal to F1 plus F2 plus F3. Okay, so we have to write down these values now. I'll see the first force. What will be this value? I'll check the denominator. 9 square plus 12 square. Then it is 15. So minus 9 divided by 15. It is minus 0.6. Okay, so what you have to do? Here we have under root 9 square plus 12 square. Calculate this value. Then minus 9 divided by this value. And this will be minus 12 divided by this value. Okay, so in that way you have to write F1, then F2 and F3 value. What about resultant? Resultant vector is given in the question. It is minus 788j. So I'll write down that value now. So resultant, it is minus 788j equal to. Now I am not showing here the simplification of this and writing down the equation here. Okay, directly I'll write down the equation in this part itself. Okay, so after simplifying that, we can write down this equation. Okay, so F vector, force vector 1, that is this equation, then 2, and this is 3. Okay, now if you consider left hand side, here we have j value. Okay, and we don't have I and k. So we have to equate I and k to 0 and j to minus 788. So I'll write down fourth step, equating I and K to 0 and j equal to minus 788. Okay, so we will get three equations. We have I, j, k. So what we have to do, I'll explain it here in short. Minus 0.6 F1, then here we don't have I. Okay, and here we have plus 0.231 F3. That will be equal to 0. So I'll write it down. Minus 0.6 F1 plus 0.231 F3 equal to 0. Now second equation I'll write for J. Okay, so J right hand side we have, it will be minus 788. Left hand side, J value here we have, so minus 0.8 F1, then here also we have J value, so minus 0.923 F2, here also we have J value, so minus 0.923 F3 equal to minus 788. Okay, next, if you consider K, again K we have to equate it to 0. Okay, here we don't have K, here we have K. Okay, so plus 0.385 F2. Then here also we have K. So minus 0.308 F3 equal to 0. So we have three equations here, equation 1, equation 2, and equation 3. How to solve these equations? We will get value of F3 first. So from this equation, you will get F1 is equal to something, okay, some constant into F3. Similarly, from this equation, you will get F2 is equal to some value into F3. Okay, so you have to substitute value from this equation and this equation of F1 and F2 in terms of F3 in equation 2. So we'll have here also F3, here also F3, and here also F3, so that we can calculate F3. So I'll substitute the values. So substitute F1, F2 in terms of F3 from 1 and 3 in 2. Okay, so I'll quickly write down the equation. Okay, so what we have done here, we have written the value of F1, okay, in terms of F3, and substituted that value here. Okay, so this will be minus 0.8 into that value. Then in second term we have F2. Okay, so from here we will replace that F2 in terms of F3. That value is written here, and last part it will remain as it is. Okay, so in this equation only unknown is F3, so I can calculate F3. F3 is equal to 400.122 Newton. Okay, and that is asked in the question. We have to calculate F1, F2, F3. So F3 we have calculated. If you consider equation 1, from 1, if we substitute F3, we will get F1. From 1, F1 is equal to 154.047 Newton, and from 3, F2 is equal to 320.098 Newton. Okay, so we have calculated all the things asked in the question. What was asked? We'll go through the question again. Resultant of three concurrent space forces. So here you can see F1, F2, F3. at A is R equal to minus 788 J Newton. Find magnitude of F1, F2, F3. So how we calculated this? First we have written all the coordinates of all the points. Then we found out force vector F1, F2, F3. Once we find out force vector, we found the resultant. Here we have to equate this. Then here on left hand side we have only J. Okay, I and K are not available. So there we have to equate 0. Okay, and J is minus 788. So we got 3 equations here. And solving these 3 equations, we can calculate value of F3, F1 and F2. So this is about concurrent force system.